Alrighty guys, welcome back to your review. This is page 5 of 5.8 to 6.1, alright? So before we start, let's go ahead and see if we can factor any of those guys down. Alright, take a look. You can't do anything there, okay? So, draw your line. You see how there's a 2? I'm going to bring that 2 down. Look at your second one. You see how it's 3v times 3v minus 2? You see how that's not written? So I'm going to bring down my 3v. Times 3v minus 2. This means you are all multiplying it all together. Okay? Let's see if I can make this a little bigger. There we go. Not too big. Alright. Now, take a look. Compare this one to each other. Let's see if I can find it. There we go. Do you see how you're missing 3v times 3v minus 2? So that's what you're going to multiply this one by. Just like that. Okay? I'm going to go ahead and bring it down. 6 times 3v times 3v minus 2, because that is what you are missing. Minus 6. What are you missing from this denominator? A 2. So I'm going to multiply this 6 times a 2. Just like that. Okay? Now we're going to continue on, and we're going to combine like terms and simplify and all that good stuff. Okay, you guys ready? Here we go. 6 times 3v is 18v. I'm going to go ahead and take care of that. 18 times 3 is 54v squared. 18v times negative 2 is negative 36v. Negative 6 times 2 is negative 12. Now, could you have simplified that right here and been smaller? That would have been just fine. Okay? Bring down your denominator. Next step. Let's see if you can factor anything out. I think 6 goes into all of them, so I'm going to factor out 6. And when you do, you have 9v squared minus 6v minus 2. All of it divided by 2 times 3v times 3v minus 2. 2 goes into 6 3 times. 2 goes into 2 1 time. Try to simplify as you are going. Okay? Next thing. 9. Times negative 2 is negative 18. See if we can factor. You know, two numbers that multiply give you negative 18 is going to subtract to give you 6v. 1 and 18, 2 and 9, 3 and 6. I don't see anything, so this would be your final answer. 9v squared minus 6v minus 2, all of it divided by 3v times 3v minus 2. Okay? Nothing to cancel out. And what can v not be? 0 and 2 over 3. There's number 27. 28. Okay? Draw your line. Bring down my 5 and x plus 1. Look at that second set. Do you have an x minus 2 in your denominator? No, so I'm going to bring that down. Okay? Now compare. I got 5x plus 1, I'm missing x minus 2, so I'm going to multiply that times my numerator. So you got 5 times x minus 2, minus 6. You got x minus 2 here, what are you missing? 5 times x plus 1. See that you're missing all of it? So you can multiply it times 5 times x plus 1. Okay. This here gives you negative 30. All right. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times negative 2 is negative 10. Negative 30 times x is negative 30x. Negative 30 times 1 is negative 30. All of that over 5 times x plus 1 times x minus 2. Do not distribute because you're trying to simplify. Okay? Next step. Combine your like terms. 5x times negative 30x is negative 25x. Negative 10 minus 30 is negative 40. All of that over 5 times x plus 1 times x minus 2. What can you factor out from your numerator? A, negative 5. When you do that, guess what you have? 5x plus 8. All of that over 5 times x plus 1 times x minus 2. Guess what happens to your 5? They cancel out. So your final answer is negative 1, or you can just write negative 5x. Okay, minus 8, because I'm multiplying it times negative 1, and x plus 1 times x minus 2. minus 2. And x cannot be negative 1, and x cannot be positive 2. There you go. Number 29, okay? I'm going to put parentheses around this. So guess what you have? 4x minus 1. X minus 4, not written, so I'm going to write x minus 4, okay? Compare. You got 4x minus 1. I'm missing x minus 4, so I'm going to multiply my numerator to keep it the same. 6 times x is 6x. 6 times negative 4 is negative 24, plus 2x. What are you missing from this denominator? 4x minus 1. Let's go ahead and I multiply first. All right, so 6x minus 24 plus 8x squared minus 2x. All of that over 4x minus 1 times x minus 4. Come on, you like terms? Let's go ahead and write x squared first. 8x squared plus 4x minus 24. You guys see that? 6x minus 2x. All of that over 4x minus 1 times x minus 1, okay? What can you factor out? I'm going to factor out a 4, and when I do, I have 2x squared plus x minus 6. All of that over 4x minus 1 times x minus 1. Continue. Bring down your 4. Let's see if we can have some terms. X and x. 2 times negative 6 is negative 12. What two numbers multiply to give you negative 12, and it's going to subtract to give you positive 1. So plus 4 minus 3, and divide that by your a. All of that over 4x minus 1 times x minus 1. Okay. All right, let's go ahead and rewrite it. So now what do you have? 4 times x plus 2 times 2x minus 3, all of it over 4x minus 1 times x minus 1. All right, is there anything you can see that can cancel out? Nope. So that's your final answer, and x cannot be 1/4, and x cannot be 1. And there you have your solution. Nothing cancels out, okay? Do check my math, just in case I mess up. All right. Let's look at number 30. Last one, guys. Okay. Draw x minus 5, x minus 2. One of each. Okay? So I'm missing x minus 2. So 2 times x minus 2 plus 2x times x minus 5. You see what I'm missing? Just like that. Continue with your math. 2x minus 4 plus 2x squared minus 10x. All of it over x minus 5 times x minus 2. Combine your like terms. I'm going to write my square first. 2x squared minus 8x minus 4. All of that over x minus 5 times x minus 2. Factor out your 2. So you got x squared minus 4x minus 2. All of it over x minus 5 times x minus 2. Alright, do you guys know any numbers that multiply to give you negative 2 and it's going to subtract to give you 4? I don't. So, since I can't do it, this is your final answer. X cannot be a 5 nor a 2. And there you have number 30. Okay, good luck, guys.